vision of what could be, and if I'd end up happy, I would pray. Trying hard to reach out, but when I tried to speak out, felt like no one could hear me. Wanted to belong here, but something felt so wrong here. So
hey everyone, welcome back to Thorns of Glory. It's your girl Beatrice, and today we are back with another video. I'm gonna give you guys a prophetic word that God has been downloading to me over the past couple of weeks. So let's just start with a prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for today, God. Thank you for your presence being in this room. I pray that you will flood the rooms and the cars or wherever your people are watching from right now, and just speak directly to their hearts, God. Let it not be me who's speaking, but fill my mouth, Holy Spirit, with your words, and let it reach each person in a unique way. In Jesus' name, amen. So quick disclaimer, always remember prophetic words, take it back to God so you can get some richer and fuller details so he can speak to you personally. The reason why I'm here giving these words is because God wants to talk to you. He wants to reach out to you. He wants to encourage you, correct you, whatever it is he wants to do. So take this word back to God and let him really explain it to you in a way that is correct for your current situation. I know in part, see in part, prophesying part, like I don't know everything. So just go back to God and let him explain everything that he wants to tell you. So I'm going to start this video by laying down kind of like a foundation of what God has been telling me. So I'm going to start with a recent one, going to the older one, and then relate it to scripture and what the word is meaning for the different people who are watching. So the intro to this video, the song that was playing was Breakaway by Kelly Clarkson. And I know you're probably listening to the song like, okay, why is she playing this? Like, this is supposed to be a gospel channel. Listen, God spoke to me through this song. So I'm just going to take the lyrics and the parts that he highlighted to me and how it relates to this word. So I'm just going to read it out because I'm not about to sing. Yeah. So it says, grew up in a small town, and when the rain would fall down, I would just stare out my window. This is one part that he pointed out to me. Dreaming of what could be, and I'd end up happy, I would pray. And if I would end up happy. Trying hard to reach out, but when I tried to speak out, felt like no one could hear me. Wanted to belong here, but something felt so wrong here, so I pray I could break away. Now the whole chorus, he highlighted everything there. It says, I'll spread my wings and I'll learn how to fly. I'll do what it takes till I touch the sky. I'll make a wish, take a chance, make a change, and break away. Out of the darkness and into the sun. But I won't forget all the ones that I love. I'll take a risk, take a chance, make a change, and break away. Now, I know it says make a wish and take a chance. Of course, we don't believe in wishes and chance. God is not a genie where we just give him like three wishes and he just snaps and it's there. No, that's not how he works. But there's a deeper meaning behind those words. So before I get into how this relates, he also started talking to me probably like, I feel like it's been all of June and July. But I actually recorded this video a couple weeks ago, but I felt like he wanted me to redo it and explain how this song basically relates to this next part. So he gave me this revelation about the process that butterflies go through, how they go through metamorphosis, I think that's what it's called, how they go from the caterpillar to the butterfly. So I'm gonna go over the different stages just to show you like how this relates to the song and relates to the word. So the first stage of the egg stage, we're not going to spend too much there. That's when the caterpillar is born, point being, period, right? So after that stage, the next stage is called the larva stage. So this is where they are getting bigger, but they still look the same on the outside. They're constantly eating so that they can grow, and they're constantly shedding skin to grow and expand. So I'm going to go through each one and how it relates to the word. So after that, it goes to the pupa stage. And after it's reached its full growth, they form a chrysalis. So that's like the little thing where the caterpillar goes in and becomes a butterfly, right? So after they go in the chrysalis, this is a quote from the website. I think it's called the Butterfly Site. And it says, it may look like it's resting on the outside, but inside is where all the action is happening. So in this chrysalis, they're able to change rapidly. I believe it happens over a week. I'm not too sure. But they're in isolation with no distraction. So they try and form the chrysalis under a leaf where not a lot of predators can get to it, or other caterpillars have their chrysalis there as well. So in this time, their old body parts are being transformed to form the body parts of the butterfiller. What? Butterfly. Oh, wow. Okay, then the final stage is the adult butterfly. And this is where they come out with wet wings. So because they're in a compact place, their wings are wet because it's like forming like in a compact place. And they come out, they're usually uncomfortable and tired. So they usually take time to rest. And then after pumping blood to its wings, it masters flying and after 3 hours, and then it looks for a mate to reproduce. And then after that, it dies. Pretty sad. So you're probably thinking, okay, like you did a Kelly Clarkson song and you're telling me about a stage of a butterfly. Like, what in the world is this prophetic word? So what God was telling me, there's two phrases that he gave me. The first one was emerge and transformation into a butterfly and also coming out, right? So when we look at the lyrics in the song Breakaway, it basically talks about, throughout the song, she talks about how she comes from a small town. She feels like she doesn't belong there. And she talks about how she wants to go to the city and look at all these things and how she wants to break away from the current state that she is in. So I'm going to relate this to the caterpillar turning into a butterfly. So the caterpillar comes out born as a butterfly, not a butterfly, as a caterpillar, but its final stage is supposed to be a butterfly, right? So of course, the caterpillar is a caterpillar for only one season in its life, but its end result is supposed to be a butterfly. So of course, like, the way I'm trying to relate this is there's a lot of people who you may be in the larva, the pupa, or emerging as a butterfly state, but you've had a season in your life where, Holy Spirit speak, you had a season in your life where you felt so uncomfortable and you felt like, okay, there's so much more to life. Like, this can't be it. And you feel like the stage or the season that you're in is coming to an end where you are literally tired of being in this place. You don't even feel like this is where you're supposed to be anymore, right? So I'm just going to go back to the different stages of the butterfly and explain each stage and what God showed me in each stage. So basically in the larva stage, when they're growing in the inside, but they look the same, this is basically like us when we come to Christ. So, of course, the egg stage, we're born again, right? But there's a period of time where we are gaining knowledge, where we are growing, and we may look the same on the outside, but inside our spirit is changing rapidly. So in this stage, they're growing. Sorry, they're eating constantly so that they can grow quickly. So just like when we're new believers, we're in our word, we're learning about God, we're learning about our identity, and we're growing quickly inwardly. The last part is really important. It says constantly shed skin to grow and expand, sheds off dead weight. So as we learn about who God is and who we are in Christ, we let go of our old nature piece by piece. So the more that we spend time in the word, the more we are transformed and we grow, and we let go of the things that really hold us back from becoming who we need to be. Okay, so the pupa stage, this is when they go in the chrysalis and they're isolated to grow. Now this is a season where God isolates you and it's just you and him, whether he removes you from friends, relationships, jobs, family, whatever it may be. He may have you in a season where he wants it to be you and him, right? Kind of like the dark room where they like process photos. It's just like, it's a time and a season where it's just you and God, and God is working on you, God is transforming you, he's molding you, he's getting rid of all of the things that are a part of the old nature and making you into the new person he wants you to be. So this is a place where you're isolated and he removes all distractions. It's just you and him, so he can rapidly change you into something else. Now the adult butterfly is for a lot of people watching this video where God is calling you to emerge. You've been in a season where God has been stripping you of things, purifying you, changing you, and I feel like the church is about to go through this stage because this quarantine corona time has been a time where God has really been stripping us of things. But for the remnant who are coming out in this season, who have went through their wilderness where God has purified them, they are coming out and emerging as a new creation in the way that the world never expected. So usually when the adult butterfly comes out, of course the wings are wet like I mentioned before, and usually it's like uncomfortable. The butterfly was a caterpillar for so long. So sometimes emerging as a new thing feels so uncomfortable. So after the butterfly comes out, it has to take a time of rest where it pumps blood into his wings and it learns how to master flying, right? So a lot of us are coming into this new season, but what God has been telling me a lot, I know you guys have been hearing about this a lot, how God is doing a new thing. A new thing is something that's completely opposite from the old, meaning that you've never experienced it before. You don't know how to manage it. It's not something that you are comfortable with because you're not used to it. So God is bringing us into this new thing, but it's uncomfortable. And sometimes we're really tired coming out of this season where God has been molding us and changing us and shifting us and purifying us. We can come out really tired. And the new that God is bringing into our life can be so uncomfortable for us to handle. But that's why it's important for us to really rest in God's presence. Like I said in my past video, the one that was talking about, that one didn't come out. But there's a video coming out that will talk about that. Actually, no. I think that was the Day of Justice video. I'm not sure. One of the videos. Just watch all of them. But it's important for us to really rest in God's presence so that he can fill us up and give us strength. The Bible says, I believe it's Isaiah 40:31. I'll put it on the screen if that's not right. But Isaiah 40:10. My bad. It says, those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And that they will soar on eagle's wings, as before. So when we come out of our old season and we're transformed into the new creature, and we don't know how to manage it because we haven't been there before, it's important for us to spend time in worship, spend time in the Word, spend time just sitting before God and saying, God, I need you. I don't know what's coming, but I need you to download some revelation to me. I need you to give me strength because where you're taking me, I've never been here before. And the adult butterfly, they're not used to being a butterfly. For most of its life, it's been in the larva stage where it's a caterpillar. And a caterpillar, just think about it, it's like a short little stubby thing. And then a butterfly looks completely different. And that's what God wants to do in our lives. He wants to take us from something that people despise, people don't look at. People look at it as ugly, like they step on it, they kill it. And then he wants to transform us into something as beautiful as a butterfly, where people have butterfly jewelry. I've been seeing butterfly jewelry, butterfly clothing, like everything. I'm buying all of them just because I like, I don't know. After this word, it's just like everything butterfly, I want it. But he wants to make us so beautiful. Beautiful like a butterfly, so that we can show forth his glory and his beauty. God wants to transform us so that when people look at us, they'll be like, wait, isn't this the person that was an outcast? Isn't this the person that people look down upon? And look what God did in their life. God wants to get the glory in our transformation, so we have to really submit to the process and let him change us. So I'm just going to go back to the lyrics of the song in the chorus mainly. And it says, I'll spread my wings and I'll learn how to fly. I'll do what it takes till I touch the sky. I'll make a wish, take a chance, make a change, and break away. Next part says, out of the darkness and into the sun, but I won't forget all the ones that I've loved. I'll take a chance, I'll take a risk, take a chance, make a change, and break away. So I'm going to go through these, and then I'm going to end out with verses. So, of course, in the beginning, it says, I'll spread my wings, and I'll learn how to fly. So that just talks about how the new thing, it's not something that we're used to. So we have to go through a process, and this really happens in the presence of God, just listening to how, what instructions and directions that he's giving you. Because remember, you haven't been in this place before. Just like the Israelites, when they came out of the wilderness, and they were going towards the promised land, there were different things that they had to fight, different enemies that they weren't used to fighting. They had to stay in God's presence. They had to seek God for directions so that the things that the enemy brought up to stop them from getting to their promised land, God could give them divine instructions on how to fight. So after it says, I will do what it takes till I touch the sky. Remember that the enemy does not want you to become the person God wants you to be, because he knows that once you become that person, you're going to shut his kingdom down and he's not with it. So he's going to constantly bring things like confusion, make you feel disqualified, fill you with fear. That's why it's so important to know God's word and to be in the presence of God. For the word says in Daniel that those who know their God shall be strong and do exploits. You are strong by spending time in God's presence, waiting on him and learning the truth so the truth can set you free. So It says that I'll do what it takes till I touch the sky. So you can see there's a level of determination that's needed to really learn how to be this new person that God is calling me. So the next, well, calling us to be. So the next part says that I will make a wish, take a chance, make a change, and break away. Remember that transformation and change is not easy. You have to let go of certain things. You have to take a chance. You have to make a change. And it will be uncomfortable at first. But I promise you, all that God has for you on the other side is so much worth it. So worth it. So much worth it. Whatever. Okay, so the next part says, out of the darkness and into the sun, but I won't forget all the ones that I love. This part is important. So, of course, out of the darkness, coming out of the chrysalis stage, coming out of the place of isolation and where God really has you hidden, and coming into the sun where your glory can be seen, right? The last line that I just read, but I won't forget all the ones that I've loved. It's important for you to remember that, yes, God is elevating you in this season, and he's making your name great. He's making you beautiful. You're shining with his glory for one reason, and it's so that he can be glorified in your life. It's important that we don't make the same mistake that the Israelites made. When God blessed them and brought them into the promised land, they forgot the same God who was with them in the wilderness. They forgot his faithfulness. They forgot his love. And they went after other idols. You have to make sure that when you go into this new season and God transforms you and you're elevated and you have new friends, you got guys or girls coming your way, you have to understand where you came from and the God that brought you here. Remember, you were just a short, stubby caterpillar that nobody wanted to talk to, that everybody looked down upon. Remember that the reason that you're where you will be in that transformed state is because of the grace of God. So do not make the same mistake that the Israelites made. Because when they made that mistake, they turned to other gods and they were destroyed and sent into exile. And we can't go into exile. Listen, Jesus is coming back soon and we have to get in our post. We must become the people he wants us to be, not just for us, but so that people can see his glory on our life and be saved, because time is running out. Time is almost up. Like, literally, it's like this much time that we have left. So we have no time to idolize other things, give our heart to other things, when God has given us his all to bring us to this place. So it ends again. I'll take a risk, take a chance, make a change, and break away. So just know that this transformation may seem risky. It may seem really uncomfortable. But what God wants to do in your life is worth it. This uncomfortable stage, just like the verse from my channel, it says that this present suffering is nothing compared to the future glory that God has for you. So yes, you may be uncomfortable right now because it's just like, okay, let's say God is telling you to quit your job, or maybe you lose your job out of nowhere, or God is telling you dress up a bit more, or start preparing yourself in this area, or I'm calling you into this calling. I'm calling you to be a prophet, a minister, an evangelist. I want you to start a YouTube channel. I want you to speak about God on your Instagram page, right? He may be calling you into all these different areas and stripping you of things from the past. But remember that he's stripping you of those things because he knows that those things, he has so much better for you. So do not settle with what is comfortable. Strive for what God has for you, because what he has for you is so much more better. So I'm going to read a verse and I'll show you how this connects to the song and the butterfly transformation. So it's Romans chapter 12, verse 2, and it says, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you'll be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. So when I was studying this verse, I think it was after I researched the stuff about the butterflies, I looked at the word transformation. So I use this app called Blue Letter Bible, and it has, I think it's called a concordance or something, but it has like this interlinear thing where it's like, if it's the Old Testament, you can look at the Hebrew word and meaning of the different words in a verse, or if it's the New Testament, you can look at the Greek meaning. So I usually do it to get more understanding, and God speaks to me a lot when I do that. So I look at the word transformation because I'm just like, okay, like, what is this in Greek? And the word that it is literally, I hope I say this right, metamorpho. So remember, the process of a caterpillar turning into a butterfly is called metamorphosis. Transformation literally means metamorpho. And I'm going to explain the definition that is on the app. And it says to change into another form, to transform, to transfigure. And then it gives another definition saying Christ's appearance was change and was resplendent with divine brightness on the Mount of Transfiguration. So that last part is relating to Matthew 17, verses 1 to 2. And it says, after 6 days, Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John, the brother of James, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. There he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothing became as white as the light. So in this time, this is when Jesus transformed into his heavenly body and he showed Peter, James, and John. So Jesus was in one state like he is in now. He's in his heavenly body, but he was in one state before they went up the mountain, right? And then when he went up, he was transfigured into something that was completely different to the point where his face shone like the sun and his clothing became as white as light. So moving on to the next verse, this verse also has the word transformed in it. So I'm just going to read it. It's 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 18. And it says, we all who with unveiled faces contemplated the Lord's glory and are being transformed into his image with ever increasing glory, which comes from the Lord who is spirit. So this is actually the verse for Glory to Glory Apparel. If you don't know, check us out at Glory to Glory Apparel on Instagram. Just had to throw that in there. Anyways, but yeah, this talks about how like when we're in God's presence and our faces are unveiled and we're just vulnerable before God, he transforms us into his image from glory to glory by the power of his spirit. And God wants us to come out of the old and really step into the new, this new state of glory, this new level of glory, so that the world can see his glory upon us and that by his grace, they will be saved. Okay, so Mark 2 verse 22 says, and no one pours new wine into old wineskins, otherwise the wine will bust the skins and both the wine and the wineskins will be ruined. No, they pour new wine into new wineskins. So this just explains why we have to go through this process of letting go of the old and stepping into the new. The old person you were in the past season cannot handle the glory, the grace, and the anointing that God wants to pour out on you. Let's just say, like me, God is calling you to be a prophet or pastor, whatever he's calling you to be in this season. The past me was fearful. The past me constantly beat myself up. I was constantly critical, judgmental of other people as well as myself. I was prideful in the sense that I was always thinking about my own good and always focused on my feelings. And then lust is another thing that I would deal with. So these things of the old nature cannot follow me as God is trying to increase me in my ministry, because these will be the things that the enemy will use to destroy me and to destroy the people around me. So there's certain things, maybe it's not like spiritual things that you're dealing with. It might be a job, like I said before. God wants to increase your salary. God wants to take you into a new career that will bring increase and prosperity into your family, not so you can sit there and buy all these things and look nice. No, so that he can receive the glory. But you are holding on to your minimum wage job that you've been at for 2 years just because it's comfortable. And God is saying, come out of the old, because what I want to pour into you for this new season, that old season cannot handle it. That fearful Beatrice cannot handle the new Beatrice that God wants to step out in glory. Go, I'm feeling it. So we have to let go of the old wineskin and step into the new so God can pour in us everything that he wants to pour into us. So next verse is Ezekiel chapter 36, verses 26 to 27. And it says, I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I will remove from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit in you and move you to follow my decrees and be careful to keep my laws. In this season, God is the one. And the thing is, I love this verse so much because it says, I will give you a new heart. It's not something that we do by our own strength. Yes, we surrender to the process, but God is saying, I want to do this change in you. He wants to do it by the power of his spirit so that you can't get the glory for this. Nobody can get the glory out of what God is going to do in your life, because it's not by might. is not by power, but it's by his spirit. And I promise you, he's going to do exceedingly abundantly above all you can ask or think. But it takes us really surrendering to the process of allowing him to remove our heart of stone. That's just a stubborn heart. That's a heart that doesn't respond to God, that doesn't obey God. Just allowing him to move that heart of stone and give us a heart of flesh, a heart that is open, a heart that is vulnerable and humble and that obeys him. He'll give us his spirit and move us to follow his decrees and to be careful to follow his laws. And when he does this, the glory of God is going to fill our lives so powerfully. The body of Christ is coming out so powerfully in this next season for the people who surrender to God's process and let him transform them. The next verse is 2 Corinthians chapter 5, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 17. And it says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come, the old has gone, and the new is here. We are no longer living in the old season. God is saying, come out and step into everything that I died for you to be. Everything that is old, everything that is of the flesh, everything that's of this world, we have to step out of it so that Christ can get the glory in our lives. The next verse is Job chapter 8, verse 7, and it says, your beginnings will seem humble, so prosperous will your future be. God is saying that you may be in a state, or you may have come out of a season, or you don't even know you're coming out. You may still be in that season, but God is telling you to come out through this video. Of course, go back and confirm with him, because we're all in different stages in our life. But you may be in a season where you feel like a caterpillar. You feel overlooked. You feel short and stubby. You feel ugly. You feel like God can never use you. You feel like you've done too much wrong, right? But God is saying that your beginnings may seem humble. It will be humble. Because his word says that, oh gosh, those who exalt themselves shall be humbled, but those who humble themselves shall be exalted. It's the humble people in the kingdom that God gives grace to be exalted. Because he knows that when you're exalted, you're not going to do it for your own glory. In that place of humility, God is able to prune you and change you and purify you so that when it's time for you to be lifted up so that his name can be glorified in your life, your heart will be pure enough to handle it. That's why he allows us to go through the thorn process. Remember, this channel is called Thorns to Glory. We go through a process of where we might have the crown of thorns, or we're going through suffering. But God allows us to go through that so that we can be purified and prepared so that when we go to the season of glory, we know how to handle it. The end of the verse says, prosperous will your future be. And that is what God is saying right now. We are stepping into a new season where he's transforming us, and yes, he's giving us prosperity. I know a lot of times in the church, we talk about prosperity gospel and how like it's not just about getting things from God and having faith just so you can use God as a genie. This is not what this is about. This is for the people who have humbled themselves, who have been faithful, who have been obedient. If you haven't watched my password called Day of Justice, go and watch that. It'll help you understand more. But these are the people who have submitted to God's will, who have let go of everything that has taken God's place in their heart. And God is saying, I will be faithful to complete what I started in you. And you're coming out of this season, this old season, you're stepping out into the new, filled with his glory, so that people can worship him because of the miracle and the transformation that he's doing in your life. So it doesn't matter where you are right now. You may feel like a caterpillar. And remember that your feelings don't matter. Your feelings are a part of your flesh. Your feelings are lying to you, because God, the enemy knows what God is about to do in your life. And it may take a day, it may take a week, it may take a couple months, who knows? Go to God, he'll tell you. But you are coming out of this caterpillar stage, this caterpillar season, to emerge as a butterfly. And remember that even in that cocoon and chrysalis, the transformation happens so rapidly. So you may be struggling with pornography. I don't know, that just came to my mind. You may be struggling with lust. You may be struggling with jealousy or pride or whatever right now. But just know that God can do it in a twinkle of an eye. He's a miracle working God. He's a God of the sudden change. Just like that. He said, let there be light, and there was light. Point blank, period. So when the appointed season comes, which is coming right now, I prophesy that over you guys. You guys are stepping into your new season. You have to submit to God and let him transform you. And let him glorify himself out of your life. Don't let the enemy lie to you and confuse you and get you to hold on to the things of the past because you're afraid of what is coming. God is a God that does not lie. His word says in Jeremiah 29, verse 11, I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, to give you a hope in the future. Do not settle for less because of fear. I'm speaking to somebody, I can feel it. Do not settle for less because of fear. Don't let the enemy tell you that you're not good enough. Don't let the enemy tell you that you'll always be a failure. Don't let the enemy tell you that you will never make it, because it's a lie from the pit of hell. Believe what God has spoken over your life and let his truth set you free. Because you're coming into, the person you're about to come, you yourself will be shocked. Like, people around you will be left in awe, but you yourself, you're going to be like, yo, what just happened? And God's going to get the glory. So I'm just going to say a prayer. And again, always take this word back to God, because we all are in different seasons. But the word that I'm speaking now, it's for the people who have been faithful and who have submitted to the process, gone through the wilderness, and are coming out into the promised land. So let me just say this prayer over you. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for what you are doing. We thank you, God, that your will is being done on earth as it is in heaven. We thank you for your beloved who are watching this video right now. We thank you for the transformation and the metamorphosis that is happening in their lives. We thank you, God, that you are transforming them, God, and from another level of glory to glory for your name's sake. I thank you for their lives, God. I pray, God, that you help them to rest in your presence, that yes, this new thing and this new season may seem uncomfortable, but I pray, God, that they will wait upon the Lord so that you will renew their strength, so they can soar on wings like eagles, so they will run into their next season and not be weary, so they can walk and not faint. We thank you, God, for being faithful. We thank you, God, for keeping your promises and fulfilling it in this time. And we thank you, God, for bringing them into this new season of glory and transforming them into your beautiful image, so that your name can be glorified on earth as it is in heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. So thank you for watching the whole video. I know it was one of the long ones, but definitely go back to God. I'm telling you, his word in Jeremiah 33 verse 3 says, call unto me and I will tell you great and mighty things that you do not know. God wants to speak to you. He wants to have a relationship with you. And if you don't know God, I'm going to say a quick prayer for you so you can experience this. Remember that God is not a genie. You have to go through a process of preparation so that when he blesses you, you'll know how to handle it. But if you are not saved, just say this prayer with me. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for today. I thank you for leading me to this video. I thank you for sending your son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for me. I admit that I am a sinner. I have done things my own way. I've gone astray, God, and I've followed the ways of this world. But I come to you now. I surrender my life. I give you my all. And I say, come into my life and take the place of my Lord and Savior. Thank you for dying on the cross and giving me access into your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen. So remember, it's not just a prayer that gets you saved. It's actually the steps of making Jesus Christ your Lord and Savior, allowing him to rule your life. And the thing is, Jesus is not, he's a gentleman. He's not a tyrant like people make him seem. He's a loving, 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 loving person. So when he rules your life, remember that word in Jeremiah 29. I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. So he always has good things for you. It may not seem like that in the meantime, but I promise you, the present suffering is nothing compared to the future glory that he has for you. So let him actually be your Lord. Give your life fully into his hands every day. You got to die to yourself and let him save you from everything that is not of him. So yeah, that's it for today's video. We'll see you guys in the next one. Make sure that you subscribe, hit the notification bell, like, share, comment, all that.